Kentucky and beyond through the company's charitable arm, Carolotta, which supports numerous nonprofit organizations throughout the region. And whereas the Bartolotta Restaurants have been a longtime member in good standing of the Wisconsin Restaurant Associations with brothers Joe and Paul Bartolotta, serving with distinction and honor as members of the WRA Board of Directors. And whereas the Bartolotta Restaurants is celebrating its 30th anniversary today, March 23rd. The Wisconsin Restaurant Association is proud to congratulate and celebrate the 30th anniversary of the Bartolotta Restaurants. Thank you.
Gotta throw a few funnies in between. So when we visited Downtown Kitchen this morning, we have a food hall and there's a salad bar. And over the last 15 years, I've had the pleasure of sitting aside Joe and Paul as they've debated about topics and what's going on. And more importantly, they debated what was to eat for lunch. So this is a thing that goes right over our salad bar. You'll notice there's no salad bar items on this table. But it reminds me of the
tater tots.
Yeah, that was not on the salad bar. But it reminds you of the banter and the love and passion that both Joe and Paul had for each other while Joe was with us. And you'll notice on the logo, you see a little fedora up there. That is in honor and remembrance of Joe. We look for advocacy in the city of Milwaukee and the greater surrounding areas, and there's no better advocate than Peggy Williams Smith of Visit Milwaukee. Peggy, would you like to come on up? So thank you for your partnership, Peggy.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Keith. I'm so grateful to be here today celebrating Paul, Maria, you, Keith, the entire Bartolotta family, and what they have done for our community. Before I start, I would be remiss to not thank Joe Bartolotta for his years of service, not only to Milwaukee, but to Visit Milwaukee as well. I am sure we all have our own special Joe story. I know I certainly do, and I'm proud that I had a chance to know him, dine with him, and call him a friend. Paul, thank you for continuing the Bartolotta commitment to Visit Milwaukee by also serving on our board of directors. And a huge congratulations to the extended Bartolotta family on 30 years of not only making Milwaukee's dining scene more impressive, but more impressive one restaurant and catering venue at a time. And that's not an exaggeration. When the restaurant that we're standing next to opened 30 years ago, Milwaukee's dining scene consisted of taverns, supper clubs, German restaurants, the occasional red sauce Italian restaurant, and a few fine dining establishments. All of that was something, but it was nothing near the heights Milwaukee's dining scene has achieved today. And what are those heights? Well, in 2022, Food and Wine declared there has never been a better time to eat and drink in Milwaukee. Also in 2022, Milwaukee had five finalists for the James Beard Awards Best Chef Midwest category and two nominations in the national category. And Paul being a former winner. And just last week, Midwest Living named Milwaukee the culinary capital of the Midwest. As someone who has worked in hospitality, as someone who has worked in hospitality, and with many of you in the audience, for over 30 years, I can say that a lot of the elevated reputation in our dining scene, that our dining scene enjoys today, is thanks to Paul, Joe, Maria, and your families, and the thousands of servers, bartenders, managers, dishwashers, chefs, sommeliers, bussers, and more who have put their best into these Bartolotta restaurants since 1993. I'm very lucky to have seen this impact first time. Late last year, we were showcasing Milwaukee to producers for a television show with a dinner featuring some of Milwaukee's most talented chefs. As we made our way through the menu of some of the best food that I've ever had the opportunity to taste, we arrived at the final entree of the night, an osso buco made by 2022 James Beard Chef of the Midwest owner of The Diplomat, Dane Baldwin. The osso buco, Dane told us, was a tribute to Paul, a 2-time James Beard Award winner himself who had once mentored Dane and taught him so much of what he knows today. Dane is just one of the many chefs around Milwaukee whose careers have been helped by or started in a Bartolotta kitchen and have since gone on to open their own successful restaurants. But that is only part of the Bartolotta restaurant's legacy. The folks you see here today have also created the gold standard for service in hospitality, which they were able to maintain even in the thick of the pandemic. Masks on, masks off, masks on. When we were hosting the USA Triathlon in 2021, the first major event since the pandemic began, it was Paul, it was Maria, it was Christian Damiano, it was Keith, it was everyone you see, HR, where's Jenny, all of them were ferrying breakfast sandwiches back and forth from the kitchens to the triathletes before their race at 6 a.m. Did you hear that? That's everyone from their corporate office was at the lakefront making sure that these athletes saw the best that Milwaukee had to offer. No matter who you are. Well, they all went on to work all their events that night, too. No matter who you are, where you're from, when you walk into a Bartolotta restaurant, their staff welcomes you with open arms and treat you with care and respect. I could go on forever about what this restaurant umpire has done for Milwaukee, but I'm going to close with one other quick anecdote that I think about often. In early 2022, when we were in the bidding process for the 2024 Republican National Convention, we worked with Paul and his team on a dinner for the entire site selection committee at Lake Park Bistro. Beautiful custom menus were created, toasts were made, the best of the best Lake Park food was served, and our local civic leaders welcomed the committee with open arms. That night, the atmosphere in the back room of Lake Park was pure joy because we got to take in these powerful, unifying speeches while dining on fare that can only be described as the Lake Park chefs completely showing off. And it was more than just the Lake Park chefs. It was all of the Bartolotta chefs. It was amazing. And little did we know it would get 10 times better after we delayed Paul 10 times to get up and close out remarks and thank everyone for coming. He started by telling some of the Bartolotta story, and then he did something bold. He told the committee members that when they left Milwaukee, they wouldn't remember the food from that night. They wouldn't remember the wine. It was good wine. They might forget some of the venues they toured, and they might not remember a thing about the hotel they stayed in. What they would remember, Paul said, is how Milwaukee made them feel, how Milwaukee welcomed them and showed off its best, how Milwaukee infused fun into what was a very serious business trip, and how only Milwaukee could deliver an experience that made them feel as if they were meant to be here all along. We were all tearing up at the end of Paul's speech, the RNC guests included, because he had just crystallized the experience that I think we, as a community, hope to deliver anyone who arrives at our front door. And there's no one better at practicing or teaching that than Paul, the late Joe, Maria, Keith, and the entire team at Bartolotta Restaurants. Congratulations again to the Bartolotta team on this incredible milestone.
Peggy, and thank you. I felt like it was a Nixon moment, right? Thank you, Peggy, and all of our friends from Visit. You know, I think of the support and the love that we have in our industry has. We think of Visit. We also think of the MMAC. I can think of no greater individual who has been such a great spokesman for our greater community than Tim Sheehy. Paul, a little, since I've been drinking champagne all day with you, a little moment of honesty. So when I started with this gig back in 2008, I thought, I'll do this restaurant thing for about a year, then I'll get really back into real business. One, quick, because, you know, you did work and then you went out to restaurants, so that's not business. You quickly realize there is an incredible business in restaurant touring and passion and love, and it's a mixture of passion and business and community relations. So once again, we're so grateful, Tim, for your stewardship for the many, many years you have and will continue, and your support of Bartolotta Restaurant. So Tim Sheehy.
So I hate to disappoint you, but I didn't bring a proclamation or a resolution, but I did bring an appetite. Yeah, so when I think of this location, and it's like picking out your favorite child, which is hard to do, but I think about this location, and for 4 years had a son playing football at Marquette, and win or lose, my wife and I would come here after every game for dinner. And so it really never mattered at the end of the day whether we won or lost, we got a great meal. But I guess just want to make two points here. So one is, if you think of great cities across the world, you think of Paris, you think of Rome, you think of Lyon, you think of Venice, you think of Florence. Great cities are built on great cultures, and great cultures are built on great cuisine. And so we're here today celebrating 30 years of a family-run business, and Joe and Paul and Maria, you've been so great in terms of lifting this city up with the cuisine that you provide to us, but you've also been very engaged in the community. So while this is an appreciation for what you're doing, from the business leaders across Metro Milwaukee and from myself personally and Keith, I just want to thank you for making this city a better place to live. Congratulations.
So we are in the heart of Wauwatosa. We love being in the heart of Wauwatosa. And we think we've got so many great people in this fine village. We're sitting in a place we have our landlord, Russ Drover, Dave Wareham, and Patricia Camp, which she follows Mark Camp, may he rest in peace. And he gave you the opportunity, Paul and Joe, to start here. Wauwatosa is an incredibly special place to us. And I think in recent times, roughly about 3 years ago, something was happening. The pandemic hit. And I remember the first call. It was from the mayor's office, from Kathy Eli at the time, said, hey, what do you need? We're here to help. We're sending you money. It was, and I said, well, excuse me. We're sending you a grant to make sure you're there, along with everybody else in the village as well. It showed the love and the passion, the commitment. And that was a moment, but there's thousands of moments in the last 30 years. We're so appreciative of the fellowship and the friendship we have with the village. So I'd love to introduce Dennis McBride, mayor of the city of Wauwatosa.
Thank you. A couple of years ago, I was, first of all, this is my hometown. It's your hometown. This is your gift to Wauwatosa, our gift to the rest of Milwaukee and the region, so thank you for that. But a few years ago, I was on a panel with a few other mayors, and I have a very good friend, Dan Devine, who's in West Allis. And he was bragging about West Allis, as he should, because it's a terrific community. And he was saying, you know, unlike Wauwatosa, where they have, you know, Bartolottas and all that, we have a lot of homegrown restaurants. And I, of course, got my shot. And I said, you know, the Bartolotta boys went to the same church I did right up the road here. And they went to all the same schools. And Joe's on the Wall of Inspiration at Tosa East. And their first restaurant is right down here in the village of Wauwatosa. I've never let them forget that. Yeah. So the Bartolottas, they're Wauwatosa kids, right? Good for you. Thank you. Thank you for starting here 30 years ago. The village of Wauwatosa, by the way, we are a city, folks, but this is called the village because this is where we started way back when. But in the village area, the village was dead 30 years ago. There were two Italian families that revived this, the Roses and the Bartolottas. And so the Chancery started across the street, and then the Bartolottas came in. And now we have one of the premier restaurant destinations, not only in the region, but across the country. Wauwatosa is a really hot spot for restaurants, and we're proud of that. And we're proud to share that with the rest of Milwaukee. I was going to read a proclamation, but much of it's been said already, but I will read the parts that deal with Wauwatosa. And by the way, we put Joe Bartolotta on our Wall of Inspiration at Toast East a few years ago, along with a Nobel Prize winner in physics and Academy Award winning actors and all. You're going to be on there one of these days, too. I'll see that. I'll see to it. But this is what the community turns out. And so I'll just read a little bit of this. The Bartolotta Restaurants is known for its top quality food and service and commitment to the community. and has grown to include several other restaurants across the greater Milwaukee area. Whereas the founders of Bartolotta Restaurants, award-winning chef Paul Bartolotta and his late brother Joe, grew up in Wauwatosa and together realized their dream of creating signature restaurants. And this is the best part. Whereas the Bartolotta Restaurants opened its first location in the Wauwatosa Village Business District in March 1993. And ever since, Ristorante Bartolotta has been one of the best Italian restaurants in the region and nation, as well as a mainstay and catalyst for economic development in Wauwatosa's village. That's what you did for us. You didn't just bring great food. You've been a catalyst for us. So thank you. And by the way, I should, as proud mayor of a proud city, at night we're 49,000 people. During the day, we're over 105,000 people. During the day, we're the fourth largest city in Wisconsin. I bet you didn't know that. People like Paul and Joe and Maria, the whole family, everything we do here, we contribute mightily to the economic success of this region. And so again, it's with great pleasure, as mayor of Wauwatosa, the city of Wauwatosa, I hereby proclaim March 23rd, 2023 to be Bartolotta Restaurants Day throughout the city of Wauwatosa. And I salute the Bartolotta family and its employees for their commitment to the community and their 30 years of providing memorable dining experiences. Thank you.
Thank you for those kind words. And I believe you guys were in school together, so maybe later we can share some stories about his time in high school. You know, oftentimes, if you're in a certain group, you get marked in a certain area. And I've always been intrigued over the last 15 years about people who say, oh, man, are you working with the city on this? Whew. Well, I have never thought of a moment where the city hasn't been generous and helpful and say, how can we help? So thank you, Mayor. The same can be very said true of our friends and partners at Milwaukee County. I see Guy Smith in attendance, and of course the county executive. And each and every time we say, what if? Time and time again, we found that answer that is symbiotic, not only for the county, not only for Bartolotta's, but our employees and the greater community. I'm really excited about where we're at as an area. It is lively, it's exciting, it's on the track for success. And absolutely one of them, County Executive David Crowley, come on up. Appreciate your energy and your excitement.
Can we give Keith a round of applause? Yeah, everybody. Thank you. He's doing good up here. So first and foremost, I just want to say thank you for this opportunity to recognize Bartolotta's 30th anniversary. Can we give them a round of applause? That's awesome. And Tim, I did bring a proclamation. I am going to read it. But before I go into it, I do want to say we appreciate the vision that Bartolotta's has brought right here in our own backyard with Milwaukee County. We appreciate the partnership, and I think that's one of the reasons why Director Guy Smith is here, because we wouldn't have been able to do half the things that we're able to do in our parks, particularly Lake Park, if it wasn't for our partnership. And what I would like to say is that the one thing that folks look at Bartolotta's is you got great food, right? But your commitment to this community has been overwhelming. But I would also say that you also provide a space that allows for people to not only break bread, to figure out how we move this community forward. And so I just want to say thank you for providing that type of venue in our own backyard. So we have an executive proclamation, and it says, whereas Milwaukee County proudly recognizes the Bartolotta Restaurants on achieving its 30-year milestone anniversary in Milwaukee County and the surrounding region, where they have become a nationally recognized restaurant and catering organization. And whereas the Bartolotta Restaurants had founded by renowned chef Paul Bartolotta and his late brother Joe, who grew up in Wauwatosa and collaborated to realize their dream of creating signature restaurants and inviting friends and family in the area to join them at the Bartolotta table. And whereas their first restaurant was opening of Ristorante Bartolotta in the Wauwatosa Village area in March of 1993, and the family went on to open up other restaurants in Milwaukee County and elsewhere, including several in the city of Milwaukee and another in the village of Greendale, all of which have a well-earned record for exceptional food and exceptional service. And whereas the Bartolotta Restaurants have achieved national recognition for its culinary skills and its founders earned a reputation as outstanding restaurateurs with high standards in restaurant operations and entrepreneurship, while also inspiring and nurturing new generations of culinary talent in the greater Milwaukee region and beyond. And whereas the Bartolotta Restaurants, through its commitment to the community and its Carolotta charitable arm, has given back to various nonprofit groups in Milwaukee County throughout its 30 years of operation. Beyond this, the greatest asset of the Bartolotta Restaurant is the team members who have been the backbone of the business and are considered family in this family-run business. Now, therefore, I, David Crowley, County Executive of Milwaukee County, on March 23rd, 2023, do hereby recognize and honor the Bartolotta Restaurants on the occasion of the 30-year anniversary and thank the organization for their contributions to Milwaukee County. So truly appreciate all that you bring. And I know my cousins work for you, so I think we're extended family now. So thank you so much for all that you do.
Relationships, trust with our partners, and certainly trust with our employees. So when we welcome employees, whether they welcome back from a journey abroad and coming back home, or we welcome them for the first time, we all say thank you for the trust you've placed in us. And I suppose that very trust started some 23 years ago with Joe and Paul when they walked across the street and they had a conversation with one Joe DeRosa. Joe, of course, owned many of the chanteries and Blue Sombrero and the original Pat Cake House. More importantly, he was a family friend and a trustee, and Paul will describe their relationship a little bit more. But we have a video. Joe is down in Florida. He finds the weather more hospitable in this moment. I find it very hot here today.
I mean, it works.
But if this works well, let's hear a word from Joe DeRosa.
Today we're celebrating 30 years of hospitality success and innovation. This relationship started with Joe, Paul, and Maria's mom and dad. I met Dad through the Italian Invitational Golf Committee, a committee that argued a lot, but had some successes also. TJ would brag about his kids a lot, all the time. And around 1978 or 9, I would learn why he bragged so much. The three applied for jobs at the chantry in the village. Only two of them made the cut. I'll leave it at that. I learned why Dad bragged so much. These kids were fantastic. Fast forward to 1992, a 31-year-old, Joe Bartolotta, sets up an appointment to see me. I'm sure at the encouragement of Dad. He wanted to talk about an idea for an authentic, traditional Italian restaurant right across the street from my office. He said the financial backer had backed out and was looking for a new partner. If Joe was here, he would probably tell the story much better. But I thought I can sit at my desk and watch the front door and the kitchen at the same time. I said, this sounds like a good investment. Had I said no, TJ would have hounded me until I said yes. So I said yes. Needless to say, I was very excited to be a part of something I knew was going to be groundbreaking for the culinary scene in Milwaukee. Milwaukee would never be the same. Thank you, Lord, for allowing me to be in this partnership. It came time to move them out of the nest, and the rest is history. Paul, Maria, thank you so much for allowing me to be just a small part in your 30 years of success. Pam and I congratulate you.
thank Paul and Joe and Maria for wonderful 15 years. I've only been here half the time. And for all you've done for our family, and I hope I say true for our families as well, it's not only 600 employees that we have, but it's touching thousands of lives. So thank you very much. And now, Paul and Maria Bartolotta.
So neither of us are particularly well scripted on this one. You have notes, good.
But
I want to actually elaborate a little bit on Joe DeRosa. It's really much more than that.
Can I just say one thing?
Sure.
I did make the cut. Just to clarify.
So did I. Nothing would be here without the two Joes. So we metaphorically talk about the Bartolotta table. We actually had it refurbished, and it sits in our office now because we want to remember where we came from. And I have so many stories to tell, but one I want to go into a little bit more detail with Joe DeRosa. So we're sitting at the family table. I came up here to see the space that Joe had found. He said, hey, this will be great. And I said to my brother, he goes, there's really a market for, you know, the kind of food that you've been training on. I think there's really a market for it. And I said, Joe, are you nuts? There's no market. And my brother's like, Paul, I'm telling you there's a market. And as always, Joe's vision, he was right. And I came up here and I saw the space and we had dinner at the house a few blocks away. And Dad, of course, said, you got to talk to Joe DeRosa. So we did go to talk to Joe. And Joe DeRosa asked me, he said, you're going to do the food? I said, yes. And he goes, Joe, you're going to be in there every day? And he goes, yes, I'm going to run it. It's going to be my baby. And he said, where are you with your money? And Joe explained that we had a potential investor that fell out, and we had raised maybe $30,000. And he said, how much do you need? And I vaguely recollect, you know, we said like $150,000. And he said, oh, that's never going to be enough. You're going to need way more than that. Joe DeRosa not only said, we will fund the lion's share of this, way more than 50%. And he also said, I want to make sure that you and your brother own 51%, so you have majority ownership from day one. I don't know who does that in business, but Joe DeRosa did that. Furthermore, about 2 weeks ago, we were cleaning up Mark Camp, Patricia Camp's office, and she handed me a folder of all of her dad's memorabilia and records, and I worked through it, and I actually found something that I didn't even aware of because I wasn't a business guy, that Joe DeRosa even guaranteed our lease, because we couldn't even have guaranteed the lease to have the property.
You think that's, he still does today?
I could call him. Who does that? And then about 18 months later, he said, you guys are doing great. I want you guys to go and do more. And he let it go. And I'm sitting here today, and I'm thinking about before we opened, and I remember I have my two nieces. I have Anna and Mary Jo's daughters that are here. Katie here? And their mom, Katie, my brother's first wife, will be here. And I remember Katie, I mean, it was a family that Katie was sewing curtains. The curtains that are hanging were sewed by Katie. I remember Katie putting up the wallpaper in the bathroom before we opened. There was only one kid around at that point, and one was aspirational, and they are the future, and we are deeply grateful for so many people who've done, and as I think back on all the people, or if you think about a day like today, today's about, like, remembering Joe, for sure. And we think back on all the different people who helped. Nothing happens in life without people helping you. And whether it be Tony May, who sent me to work in Italy and France, whether it be Joe DeRosa, who followed our careers and then believed in us, whether it be someone like Michael Cudahy, who helped us find Bacchus and then later helped fund and give us an opportunity to discover the world, and then later was the financier and partner to help us start and do Harbor House, and I can go on and on. Roy Ryman and Green, and all these people have created opportunities for us. And we, in turn, have tried to do our best, always, to figure out how we can create the same opportunities in our small way for the people that work for us, for the communities in which we operate. And we have Carolotta because when we built our tenants around that Bartolotta table, it was built around all the things that our parents taught us, taking care of people. The word care was always part of it. Our home was open for boarders. We had people living in our house for not a week at a time, but months, even years, people that were in the middle of a divorce, or my dad would be like, come live with our family, and like, son, you're on the couch. And that's what we grew up with, people in the neighborhood on 71st Street. It was always Saturday and Sunday at the Bartolotta family, eating snails or eating weird food and all this thing that all the neighbors. And I remember as a kid going to school at Lincoln one morning, and it was a horrifying morning. It was snowy and I was traditionally late, and I came in and I took off my coat and I threw my lunch pail. You know, remember those metal pails with the clips? And I threw it on there and I ran into class, and about noontime there was this terrible smell. And we go outside, they see the lunch pail, they open it up, and my dad had made me octopus salad for lunch. And I was mortified, I was so humiliated. I went home and said, Dad, I want a ham and cheese sandwich, I want chips, I want an apple, I want to be like everybody else. But little did I know that what they were actually giving us was something that would serve us for the rest of our lives, that today it's a badge of honor when you're a little kid, you're like, I want to be like everybody else, but I didn't know that our culture, our family values, our food history was all interwoven in this. And my brother had this incredible gift for first never seeing an obstacle. He was incapable of seeing a problem. He says, we're just doing this, it didn't matter. And he found this location, it's like a little castle. He found Lake Park Bistro located on this bluff, and when this one was running and he realized we weren't really, since a little restaurant was hard to make any money, it's like I built myself a job. And it used to be Peter Piper Pancake House, and of course, as good boys, we would always, you know, skip out of Mass at St. Bernard's, go eat pancakes, always remember to go and grab a bulletin so you had proof that you went to Mass, tell them how great the Mass was and how important it was to our soul. And of course, my dad, who had was a little bit crass, would look at me and say, son, you cannot bullshit a bullshitter. But we learned a lot from our parents. And my brother had this gift for finding incredible locations and just creating opportunity out of nothing. And then by being honest and trustworthy and caring about our employees, opportunities seemed to find us. And we were every year having a new opportunity. So to the employees that are here in the room and those that are in the other prepping, and to the people that were at our party today, it's really about the people that make it happen every day. They're the people that make the Bartolotta table. We can't be in all the restaurants. Joe knew early on that it was about building a culture about people. Because we're not in the restaurant business, but ultimately we're the people business. And that's what we do. So on this day, I'm humbled, but I'm also very much touched. And it has really moved me thinking about all that we went through. One more silly anecdotal story about people in community. When we were first opening Ristorante, Peter Maki, Tony Maki's son, came here and he said, I have a new produce company and I'm here to see if I can do some business with you, and I'm friends with your father. And Joe said, you know, go down and speak to my brother downstairs. He's in the basement prepping and see what foods he needs for the opening. And I said, you know, I need fresh basil and I need fresh thyme and I need fresh rosemary and I need fresh bay leaves. And he goes, you know, Paul, maybe you have that stuff in Chicago. I said, we don't have that stuff in Milwaukee. And I was like, well, start driving. And today Peter Maki has 18 trucks, big business. He has served in every one of our businesses. And when the world ended a couple of years ago, it seemed like it was ending, we get calls from him and we say, hey, listen, you know, our faucets are off on revenue. we have a lot of bills from a couple of months ago that we have to like try to catch up on in our payables. And the answer was, well, we're not worried about you. We're not worried. You just do what you need to do. And this happened across the board. Keith met with every one of our vendors. We met with everybody. And everybody, our landlords, our vendors, all came to us and said, how do we help you? And then I had people calling and saying, we want to buy, you know, gift certificates at the holidays because we want to make sure you survive. And by the way, I will tell you, it was touch and go for sure. And so it's been, I don't think I ever fully personally had an opportunity to grieve my brother's loss, because I went from that to COVID like almost in a nanosecond. But the things that sustain me is the support of the community, of course, my family. I'm so sorry my sister Felicia's not here because she was doing the accounting downstairs in the beginning. When we first did, she did all the accounting in the morning at Ristorante when it first opened for the first year or so. Everybody pitched in. It was a family affair. So I just, I miss my brother every day. Somebody said to me earlier when I said it's impossible shoes to fill, he said, well, actually, just follow in his footsteps and keep going. And so there's an old adage in the restaurant business that they say, you know, restaurants don't get tired, owners do. And I can assure you, I am not tired. And we are going forward. We're doing new things. We're excited about the future. We have not done our best work yet. And there's a lot of mentoring still to be done. So thank you all for being here. Thank you, my employees. It's really, it's all about the employees. I have been long waiting.
No, you've been doing beautifully. I just want to say how grateful we are to everyone in this room, to our employees. None of this would happen without them. We have employees in this day and age that have been with us 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 years.
More than 70.
That doesn't happen. We are so blessed because of the people that have blessed us in our lives and that work for this company. That is truly a gift to my brother, Paul, and to my brother, Joe. They started it all, and they're continuing it. And to our staff. And to you, everyone sitting here, you have helped us. You have made us get to this 30th year. I am so grateful. And like Paul said, the future is endless. We are going places. We are. With all your help. Thank you.
Thank you. People have shared so much with us. The finders, the employees have shared a piece of their lives with us. And for that, they've all left a little piece of themselves in our business. I want to take one moment and acknowledge. So today we're talking. I apologize. But I also want to just acknowledge one more individual. Juan, would you come up here, please? Juan. I don't think I can single out a single person who has made a contribution and then not mention another 100 people in our company that have done something. But today we're celebrating 30 years with Bartolotta Restaurants, but we're actually really having a birthday for his restaurant. Juan, I would like you to tell a little bit about your journey. And I am I'm super proud to call you a friend.
Well, I don't know what to say. I wasn't invited for, but I know you can do this.
Nothing like putting him on the spot.
We started together at Spiaggia
in 1996. Yeah.
In 1996, and you've been with us ever since. Then. How long have you been the chef here?
2001. So long time. So yeah, it's a long story. I don't mean to get long.
You're all fine
here, but yeah, exactly. But yeah, essentially, I wanted to cook Italian food. I was in Colorado, and one of my mentors there, my early mentors, I should say, suggested that I work for Paul in Chicago, as he was one of the best, if not the best, Italian chef at the time. I did that. It took me several tries to land a job with him, because at the beginning, There were no opportunities for me, and but I kept insisting until I was able to land the job. And then a couple of years later, Paul sent me to Italy to continue my education. Came back, Joe and him were opening Nona Bartolotta, it's now Mr. B's in Brookfield. And the initial offer, I remember when he said, hey, you know, when you come back, I want you to go to Milwaukee, help us open up this restaurant. I'm in Chicago, I trust you, and you can help us out. I wasn't sure. I had never been to Milwaukee. I didn't know how much of a wonderful place it was. Little did I know that I would form a family, I would buy a house, I would make pretty much my life here. And at the time, I wasn't sure. Paul convinced me. He said, look, you know, just help us out. A couple of months after that, if you want to go back to Chicago, you can. You better want to go back to Italy and continue your education, you want to stay, whatever you want to do. And I'm still here, so the rest is history. Help that the initial money offer was almost double what I was making in Chicago. that definitely made it easier. We had a great experience at Nona's. We later transformed it to what is now Mr. B's. And I quickly sort of found myself out of my element. I continue, and my passion is Italian. Obviously, we're doing the steakhouse, and I was doing all these like specials, pasta specials and everything. And I remember one day Joe came to me. He's like, "What? Wow, you're so out of your element here." And he was trying to convince me to come here. The first opportunity that was available, I came over, and nothing. It's been a great journey ever since. I put my life into this restaurant.
Joe's.
I found a place here, and I'm very proud. To be a part of this great community because I live right over here, 5 minutes away. After so many years, I'm proud to be a member of this community, the city, and be a little part of what makes this city of Tulsa so great. Very proud to be able to work with Paul and the family, and also most importantly, I've met so many people throughout this. 25 years. It'll be 25 years in August that I've been in this company. I've met so many people, and I'll reach out to me for the rest of my life. So thank you so much for giving me the opportunity, and you know, we're here, hopefully, strong, going into the future. So thank you so much.
We're doing champagne toast inside of Ristorante, so if you want to work your way over there, I think you're going to go.
I just wanted to thank Keith, too. Keith is amazing.
I think we'll have him go get that.
Get my mullet correctly.